Thank you all. It's great to have a beautiful night. Have all you beautiful people out there. Appreciate your attendance, and we thank Mother Nature especially. For those of you who may not know us, we are the Ridgeway Brass, and we're called that from a spurt of creative genius because all of us have a past or present relationship with this place. Now, what you have to realize is that tonight is really about one of us. I mean, really about one of us. It's about Micah, okay? Micah is leaving us in a couple of weeks. He's heading off to college, okay? He looks so innocent now, doesn't he? Heading off to college, leaving behind his much coveted trombone seat. Why would he do that? We have no idea. Okay, but Micah chose tonight's playlist. We made the big mistake of giving him the freedom to choose these pieces. Now, in every program, we have at least one tune we refer to as a barn burner. It's kind of fast, it's long, it's hard. Well, Micah, bless his heart, chose not one, not two, but three. So, anyway. Before we proceed, I want to introduce everyone to you. Ron Howe on trumpet. Yay. Mike Schmale on, now take your time, trumpet. Flugelhorn, hold it up, flugelhorn, and overgrown trumpet, and piccolo trumpet. Okay. Where do you see that big body try to put air through that tiny horn? Mike Bidgood-Enders on tuba. Micah, what? Greg, who is that? Greg, you look so much like him. Micah Bidgood-Enders on trombone. Our featured artist tonight. And myself, Josh Stroop, on the horn. Now, you can well imagine that when Micah chose the playlist, he also chose pieces with lots of trombone. Okay. Now, this next piece doesn't necessarily have lots of trombone, but, you know, we asked him why did he pick it. He said, I liked it. So it's Jeannie with the Light Brown Hair. It's a nice, mellow arrangement, and I think you'll enjoy it.
Thank you.
Thank you. You know, we think it's pretty odd that Mike is actually bothering to go away to college. Because, you know, playing trombone with the Ridgeway Brass has been his lifelong dream. Now, I know, I'm not kidding about that. From about the time this boy could talk, he was saying, Mr. Stroop, when can I join the Ridgeway Brass? Mr. Stroop. So we threw a lot of hurdles in front of him. We told him he had to learn how to do squat thrusts, which we claimed we did before every rehearsal, every practice. We then sent him on a mission to find a tubometer, which is a very specialized piece of equipment that tracks the walking cadence on a tuba. And so he went and asked his band director, do we have a tubometer here? Only to discover that it's kind of like a snipe, okay? Anyway, so over and over again, he says, can I join? So finally, maybe he's with us, what, a year and a half, 2 years now? And so he's leaving. He goes away to college after all this time. Anyway, so this next piece is Barn Burner Number One. Has lots of trombone.
Yay.
And it is called Bill Bailey.
Thank you.
Now you see why he chose that one. Going to college does seem a bit odd for yet another reason. Okay. It frankly seems kind of unnecessary to us because we've been teaching Micah so many things since he joined us, right? We have tried and tried. He even admitted one night, he said, "Why am I even bothering to go to college? I learn everything I need to know right here. Think how much cheaper it would be." Okay. All right, so this next one, we're going to change pace. Micah apparently likes to change pace. Fast, slow, fast. Here we go, slow again. Leonard Cohen wrote a beautiful piece called Hallelujah. Wrote it back in 1984, and there's so many arrangements. It's unbelievable how many arrangements there are of this piece. Go on YouTube sometime and check them out. So there's not a whole lot of trombone in this one. Okay, but he liked it. Mikey likes it, so we're doing it. Hallelujah.
Thank you.
Now we're going to go from the sublime to the ridiculous. Herb Alpert, Tijuana Brass. Okay. Two pieces that Ron has this genius ability to, like, take two unrelated tunes and smash them together and make it, calls it a medley. So we're going to do a medley of Lonely Bull and Spanish Flea. Okay. By the way, Herb Alpert did not write these. He was just the band, the group that made them popular. Who knew? Two different composers for these two pieces, neither one of which is Herb Alpert. So, here we go. Lonely Bull and Spanish Flea.
Thank you.
Those of you who have been with us before know that Micah can change from this sweet persona to a nasty, growling trombone player. And he's going to show that in the next piece, which is called St. James Infirmary. And we were informed by his grandfather last time that James is his middle name. Right, Jay? Okay. Just checking. Everything up here is totally accurate. So anyway, it's a grisly tale that if you look up the story, it's suitable for adult audiences only. It really is a grisly tale. It's based on a 18th century traditional English folk song, believe it or not, but it doesn't sound like that at all. So, St. James Infirmary, and Mike is going to growl. Lots of mutes here, too. You're going to see a lot of mutes going on here.
Yeah.
Now we're going to get slow and melodious again. This is a piece that you're hearing us play for the first time. Hopefully it won't sound like that. It's a piece that was popularized by Josh Groban, okay, but is actually composed by a Norwegian-Irish duo named Secret Garden. And, get this, the vast majority of YouTube views of this piece are not by Josh Groban, but by an Irish boy band called West Life. They have over, how many? 100 million views as of July 2021. I didn't look up how many Josh Groban had, but it wasn't that many. And it's called You Raise Me Up. Again, there's not a lot of trombone here, but Michael likes it. And so it is our first performance. We think we've got the kinks worked out, but I think you'll enjoy it.
Thank you.
Maybe it's because we raised the boy up, huh? We raised him up. Okay. This next one is Barn Burner number 2. And it is called Nearer My God to Thee. Supposedly played as the Titanic went down. Just saying. But it does tell the story of Jacob's dream from Genesis 28. And there's some virtuoso trombone playing going on at the beginning here. We have kind of a Salvation Army style beginning. And you want to especially listen for the artistry on the tambourine. It's astounding. So, the first few lines, just try not to be distracted by the tambourine completely. Okay.
Thank you.
Thank you. See what I mean about all that air going through that little tiny trumpet over there? Okay, we need your help for this one. Those of you who have heard us before know this drill. Okay, it's part of the Pink Panther. And it's part of setting the mood. Because Henry Mancini, yeah, we spare no expense. A spineless panther. And Henry Mancini, instead of saying, you know, play it smoothly, play it happily, he says, play it groovy misterioso. Honest to goodness, that's what it says on there. Groovy misterioso. So, your job is to create the groovy misterioso effect. And you're going to do that by snapping your fingers. Okay, so warm up. Loosen up. Okay. Now, this snapping only happens for the first 8 measures. After that, stop snapping. Because you'll either screw us up or have big trouble trying to stay with it. So, first 8 measures, watch Ron or me. If you're closer to Ron, watch Ron. If you're closer to me, watch me. If you don't want to watch either one of us, that's okay. So, watch, we're going to cue you for the correct snapping sequence, okay? It's on the off beats. Not everybody can do this. It's on the off beats. So pay attention. Ron will guide some of you. I will guide the others of you. And we're going to do Pink Panther. While you're snapping, by the way, the tuba and the trombone, I don't know, they do some rigmarole in the background. That's way less important than our snapping, okay? We've heard some good snapping before, but, well, it was okay. Anyway, you've heard of Christmas in July. Well, it's barely July. And Micah has another piece that he picked for us. I'll let him tell about this one.
So my mother and sister aren't going to like this. But since it's July and celebrating Christmas in July, the next piece is Frosty the Snowman.
The top hat. Okay, not this hat. His great-great-great-grandfather? Wow. Thank you. Thanks for sharing that. Okay. And thanks to Frosty. Give him another hand.
All right.
Not going to even talk about this piece. It's short. It's fast. It shows off Micah's slide skills. So listen. Back when Micah was about a wee lad, we played this tune a lot. And he probably got tired of it, but he picked it anyway. And I can remember one evening when we were setting up at Brethren Village, and we were introducing the members, and of course Micah at that time was a roadie, he wasn't a member, and he was back in the back of the room operating the camera. And he would remember, by the way, he would remember to turn it on when his father would forget to turn it on. Anyway, I said, "And Micah, what do you do for us?" And in one word, he just looked at me and he said, "Everything." true story? Everything. He was thinking that night. He must have gotten this tune into his blood or something because he chose it for tonight. And it doesn't necessarily have a lot of trombone in it. It's got some. But and you've heard it many times. It's kind of one of his old favorites. And it's called Three Spirituals. Okay. The first spiritual is Go Down Moses. And it's a fast-moving, happy piece. The second one is called My Lord, What a Morning. Really nice, mellow duet trio piece. And then the final part is called Joshua, and it keeps going fast and hard till the very end. So, three spirituals. Thank you. Thank you. And now for barn burner number three. Most smart groups would have stopped right about now. But no, Micah wants to play one more. Though it's a good one, though. We really like playing it. It's one that, you know, every group, musical or vocal, has some numbers they just like to do, right? And they enjoy them from beginning to end. This is one of them. And it's called That's a Plenty. And hopefully that does not sum up your feelings about our program tonight. Okay, barn burner number three. It's a 1914 ragtime piano piece. And it's now considered part of the Dixieland repertoire. And it motors right along. Greg will probably need oxygen at the end. A good walking tuba part, good bone parts, good everybody's part. So hang on, and here we go. Extra hand to Mike on the piccolo, and to Greg at the other end on the tuba. Well, we're going to end with our typical last piece. But before we do that, we want to say publicly a big thank you to Micah. Give him a hand, would you? He jumped in when we needed him. And what you need to know is his primer, I'll call it his primary instrument, is that okay? Is euphonium. And one of the conditions for joining Ridgeway Brass was learn how to play the trombone. So what if he didn't do? He went and learned how to play the trombone. So here he is. So we thank you so much, Micah. You've been a big help for many months. So we're going to end with a version of The Saints, Go Jazzin' In. And this was originally written as a quartet. And our good friend Sarah Schmale, who is Mike's wife, who is a composer, arranger of great renown, right? Now, yeah, she decided she was going to write a fifth part. So she wrote a fifth part for the piccolo trumpet. I think she wanted to see how hard she could make it for you. But it's a really nice part that adds a lot of layers to this tune. So The Saints, Go Jazzin' In. And before we end with that, I will say, those of you who didn't come from the press and did come from the ice cream, soon it's time. Right inside these doors, you will find the stuff I put off with behind the microphone. Anyway, go in that door, and there will be good people in there helping you enjoy some ice cream. And please stay and meet one another. I want to thank some friends of ours who came all the way from Lititz, the Roots and the Stookies. They're right there, who drove down. And I hope you'll make an effort to meet them. They're really nice folks. So, The Saints, Go Jazzin' In, and then you can go ice creaming.
Thank you.